Hey, what's up, guys? This is Gabriel Lemain, aka Z-Slash, here at Comic-Con with
Peter Cooper.
Peter Cooper is an artist in Spy vs. Spy and several other works. Can you tell some of us who are less familiar with your work, like about some of
the stuff? I've done adaptations of Franz Kafka and Metamorphosis. I do other graphic novels, a lot of travel books. I spent some time in Mexico. I'm working on a graphic novel about that. And I do illustration work for magazines.
Yeah. Here at Comic-Con, you do seem like an oddball in that you have some political cartoons here. And unlike, I guess, a lot of other political cartoons, like, your work seems a lot more alive than the kind of fare that we often see in the newspapers.
Yeah, well, then you're seeing less of it in newspapers. It's going to be harder to get that kind of work. And there's fewer newspapers.
This actually is something that's kind of been interesting to me. That, like, later, like, I guess when I was younger, like, in the late 90s, like, there was more diverse types of work with political cartoonists, and now, like, a lot of the work is kind of become kind of watered down.
Yeah.
Other than those guys like Will Bohr.
Yep.
Yeah, and like Tom Morrow.
That's brilliant work, and thank you. We need to figure that around. But it's getting harder and harder to find venues for those kinds of opinions. For a lot of different reasons, but a lot of it has to do with the fact that there are fewer outlets of print these days. There's probably a lot more on the web, but there's also, it seems to me, a sort of a malaise in terms of people who are interested in background political topics in the world. And I think there's probably a lot of reasons to go on and on about that, but it's not happening. But I just, in my experience, that's what's been going on, and so I've done more longer projects rather than individual searches. And I also got burnt out from doing so much screaming about journalism. And so it's not like there's not a lot to scream about, but I started to feel like I was singing one note.
I see. So like after screaming so much, you can only get so hoarse.
Yeah, I mean, I'm looking at how to talk about these things in different ways. And I think I'm interested in longer form stories as well. And comics are an agreement with medium to tell a much broader story. So, you know, that's very appealing.
So, what about this Oaxaca Diario de Oaxaca?
I lived in Oaxaca for 2 years. And I was just keeping, I keep a sketchbook always. And it just, there was a whole lot of political strife down there. And so it went from being originally I was just thinking about going down there for a little escape from the Bush years, and there turned out to be this huge teacher strike that lasted for 7 months.
Wait, this is during the Vicente Fox protest?
Yes, exactly. And there was about 20 some people got killed, and it was all happening right in front of me, so I started drawing about it, and that ended up being turning into a book.
So what kind of things you talk about the led up to the strike, or like looking around the community?
Actually, the book is much broader than that. It's really kind of like the experience of coming. It's a fictionalized, but it's the experience of a couple coming to Mexico, and at the same time, it's talking about the flight of the monarch butterfly to come down from Canada.
Yeah.
And so there's a lot of parallels between their travels and the struggle that you know the natural world is going through. And then the struggles that happen with teacher strike. So it's a mashup of a lot of different ideas.
What about your latest work with Diary of New York?
This one is it's essentially like a sketchbook / illustrations, comics. It's pretty much everything I've done over the last 30 years boiled down to one book. And I hope it kind of captures the feeling of that period, and it was a chance to, it's sort of a love letter to New York too, because I'm such a fan.
I have to ask, as a lifelong New Yorker, like, very often when people write love letters to New York, they often truly are love letters to Manhattan. You give Brooklyn and Queens and the Bronx love?
There's not a whole lot of love flowing around the other boroughs because I lived in Manhattan, and so it's focused on where I live.
Okay.
So that's the short answer. But it's not for lack of love. It's for what was right. Like I was drawing, you know, draw what you know.